Lynn McGee of the Echo Company, two of the 334th 3rd Brigade, 95th Division.
First of all, I'd like to thank Dave for having me out here. And I'd like to give a huge thanks to all the veterans that are here today. I, for one, want to thank you for your service. But most importantly, I'd like to thank the family members. They make what I do and others like me possible. I want to support our loved ones back home, friends and family. We cannot do what we do. Support of great folks like you all. You guys make it happen. Dave asked me to talk to you guys today about what the military is. Well, to me, that means we're going to have to talk a little bit about history. One thing I've learned in all my years, I have to ask an expert to learn about history. Captain Rob Mellon, commander here in Quincy, but more importantly, history, World UHS, answered the phone call for the technical protector. Truly the best he knocked out was from a protection on Quincy. This is our trick for a battle-tested U.S. Army. The American military was essential. Our revolution remains vital to protecting our freedoms today. In fact, the military predates the United States. These revolutionary citizen soldiers that took up arms against oppression formed into militias, Continental Army, Navy, and Marines. From the first major battle of Bunker Hill in 1775, when the Americans held out against a superior British force, to the ammunition gunpowder was gone. The American fighting spirit was born. Been on display around the world for more than 200 years. During our darkest hours, General Washington crossed the Delaware River on Christmas night of 1776 to save our revolution, which would gain separation from Great Britain at the Battle of Yorktown in 1774. Our work was still not done. Whether in the British invasion,